Sayyid Rais.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. President, it gives me pleasure to convey the greetings of the government and people of Qatar. At the outset, I would like, on behalf of Qatar, to congratulate you and the members of the General Committee on your election, and I hope that this will be an opportunity for the national authorities to exchange views and for the member states to take stock of the achievements made in the last year and to exchange information and experience in order to work together to achieve the objectives of the CWC. I would also like to take this opportunity to congratulate Peter Goosen, Ambassador of South Africa, who is presiding over this session, and we trust that, thanks to his diplomatic skills and experience, will lead this session to a complete success. I would also like to endorse what has been stated in the non-aligned and China statement made by Iran. Qatar is always keen to meet its obligations and to strengthen international peace and security, so we have joined all the international agreements, amongst which CWC. We signed CWC in 1993, and we ratified it on the 13th of August 1997. And since then, we spared no effort and in very steady steps to support the implementation of the CWC and to support its activities. We have worked in order to achieve all the objectives. Therefore, we have established our national authority on the 4th of October 2004, and this is the authority tasked with taking the necessary steps and measures and to follow up the implementation of the CWC with the other ministries. On the 30th of July 2007, we enacted the law number 17 on the prohibition of chemical weapons, and this, of course, reflects the importance Qatar attaches to the implementation of this convention. Qatar also is keen to participate in all the meetings organized by the OPCW and the annual meeting of the national authorities. Not only we attend all the meetings, but we hosted a number of activities. And in this respect, we have hosted, as of 2008 and until the year, 8 workshops, meaning 2 workshops every year, one of them for the national authorities of the Asia countries and the other one for the customs officers in the Gulf Cooperation Council countries. Many subjects were dealt with during those workshops in order to help implement the CWC and to help the countries do that. We, of course, look forward to the future activities of this organization once all the chemical weapons were destroyed. And we also call for the full implementation of Article 11. And this, of course, should be done while allowing for the developing countries to make use of the technology for peaceful uses in different areas, in agriculture, in research, and in the medical field and any other field. And the United Nations has declared 2011 as the year of chemistry, and we hope that other years will be designed in the future for this chemical year. We have hosted from the 20th to 22nd last year a workshop on the safety and security, chemical safety and security for the members of the Middle East. 50 people took part in that. It was an opportunity to build human resources. We will be hosting another workshop on chemical safety and security for the Asian countries from the 11th to the 13th of December this year. We have already hosted, or we welcomed two or four trainees within the associate program for 3 weeks. Mr. President, we know the importance of the outreach and raising the awareness of the CWC. Our national authority organizes annually and since 2007 a national workshop for raising the awareness of those who work in the chemical industry and how to deal with the declarations and those declarable items and how they should be entered into declarations. This year we decided that these activities will include the private sector and the businesses and those who work in customs. In 2011, we have started organizing a training course for students in the secondary school so that we can raise their awareness of the CWC. And this year, we also started organizing annual training courses for university students. Mr. President, we would like to thank the member countries that elected us to be members of the Council. And I would like to say in this respect, since we have become members of the Executive Council, we try to work as hard as we can and to participate in the deliberations of the Council. I would like to say that you can always count on our support during the coming years. Mr. President, Qatar, and in trying to increase its contribution, it has taken an initiative to establish a regional center in order to help implement Article 6, 10, and 11. And this, of course, will help also undertake some other activities in the fields of non-proliferation, and also for the CTBTO and for the Biological Weapons Convention. All these conventions could be, of course, included in this program. And we have received some support for establishing this regional center from some Asian countries. So I would like to take this opportunity to thank these Asian countries for their support. I would like to thank OPCW for the support. And this center will start its operations in the near future. Mr. President, Qatar is still asking the countries which remained outside CWC to join as soon as possible so that we can achieve the universality of CWC. We also look forward to the day when the possessor countries will have destroyed all their chemical weapons and arsenals so that our convention will keep its credibility and it will be an example to be followed by other international agreements and conventions. I wish that this statement be considered as an official document of this session. Thank you for listening.